are because of love, because the Lord doesn't want to see his people suffer. God gets no pleasure in seeing you in pain.
That's right.
Whether it be physical,
that's right,
or mental. He doesn't want to see, he gets no pleasure in that. I think one of the biggest hoaxes was when the devil fooled everybody and made them think God was causing them pain. To make them think that he would do something to that, to someone that he loves so much. He's so loved. Love,
yes.
So loved.
Yes, so loved.
And so it's so crucial that we realize that it's because love we want signs and wonders, not because we want to focus or point to ourselves. Mm-hmm. Our motive cannot be about ourselves. You don't want to lay hands and see someone get up and walk because of you.
Right. That's right. Amen.
Because you love them and you want to see the best for them.
Yes.
That you want to realize that, you know what? All that I have, I'm going to extend that to you.
Amen.
You all understand the story of Peter and they were going to the temple. I should find that scripture and read it because it was very good. It talks about, in the book of Acts, and you all know the scripture because he says, silver and gold I have not.
Uh-huh.
Right?
Mm-hmm.
And the funny thing is people made that about money.
Right.
Come on, what was it?
And they'll always, you know, use that to keep from giving folks something.
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
When,
so true. Yeah.
Right, man, God? And it wasn't even about that. First of all, he was sitting in front of the temple.
Uh-huh.
Now understand this, because Peter and those different ones, they were ministers, they were teachers. They really knew that you did not enter the temple without finances. Do you get that? You didn't enter. Do you know that that goes to this day?
Yes.
Okay, my son was sharing with me about a friend of his who was no longer able to go to the temple. Because they had not paid their dues.
That's right.
Yes.
They, right? And so they do that to this day. So to think that Peter was saying, I ain't got no money to give you. But such as that's not what it was about at all. Okay? Because you didn't go to the temple without money. And so that's why he was, you know, now the other thing is the crippled man that was sitting there.
Right.
See, if you understand the scriptures, and it's all about rightly dividing the word of truth,
yeah.
Again,
yeah.
If you read Leviticus, the Levitical laws would not permit them in the temple if they were maimed,
mm-hmm.
crippled,
mm-hmm.
lepers. It's in there, just read it. You couldn't even become a priest, even if you were of the blood of the Levites, if there was something considered to be a blemish or a blot
mm-hmm.
concerning you. So that's why they sat him in front of the temple. In fact, they had a place for all what they considered invalids to sit because they wouldn't allow them. First of all, it was the priest. They couldn't become a priest. But then they took it even further, and nobody who had any kind of ailments could come in to the temple. I wonder if you get the spiritual significance of this. Okay? And so, yeah, it's very important because when you start getting a better picture of the culture, because we read from American eyes.
Right.
Rather than understanding from the cultural living that they were. And so he's sitting there waiting for something, you know, to be given to him. And there's a much better Hebrew interpretation when he says, silver and gold have I not. The better interpretation is silver and gold will not help you. But such as I have.
Yes. Yes.
See what I'm saying?
Yes.
So what did he do? He took him right out of that
right.
realm and brought him right into the dimension of God.
Right, yeah. Amen. Mm. Yes.
Stepped right in, because first he said, look on me. He did this all in
right.
You know, I can't remember it without vision.
Yeah.
He said, the first thing he said is, look on, get your eyes on, look on me.
Right.
When we get to that level where we can tell people, look at me. Guess what? They're not going to see your flesh. They're going to see the Holy Ghost.
Come on.
Right.
Come on.
That's right.
Come on.
They're going to see the Spirit of the living God all over you. And all of a sudden, it's going to take them from where they are.
Right.
and bring them in. Now watch it, because when you read the scripture, he says, such as I have, rise up, get on up and walk, glory to God. And you would think that the scripture would focus on him walking or being excited or being happy or being healed. The word for word, it says, and he got up and went in the temple. See what the focus was on? Glory to God. That now you can enter in. Hallelujah. You're no longer on the outside. When we walk in signs and wonders, we are taking people from the outside and bringing them into the dimensions of God, which is where they belong. Glory to God. But you got to have it so you can give it.